You're looking at my current collection of surf skates, and right here is the very first one I ever bought, the Carver Tyler 777, which I bought October 15, 2020 at Status Skate Shop in Carlsbad, California. Now, since buying that first one, I've actually invested over $16,000 on more than 60 surf skates from 27 companies in 11 countries around the world, and that includes 28 different surf skate trucks. Now, I have not bought all of these surf skates to build a personal quiver for myself. I've not bought all of these because I thought that buying more surf skates would make me a better rider. I haven't bought them because I'm rich. I did it for one reason only, and that's because when I got into surf skating, I realized how hard it is to choose surf skates. There are so many different companies and trucks on the market, and there's lots of different models with all those different companies, and there's hardly any education on any of them. And so when I started my YouTube channel, that was one of my very first goals, was to help consumers save time, money, and hassle by choosing the best surf skates for them. So after investing all this money and doing all this research, I've boiled down all of these different surf skate trucks to what I believe are the top 10 in the world, which are Sweltech, Curfboard, Smoothstar, Aquilo, Spice Skate, Waterborne, Yao, Carver C7, Carver CX, and Slide. So in this review, I'm going to give you a solid overview of all of these 10 different surf skate trucks to help you save time, money, and hassle in choosing the best surf skate for you. Now, if you want to save even more time, you don't even have to watch this review. You can go to surfskate.love right now and get my ultimate surf skate selector. The surf skate selector includes 114 models from these top 10 trucks that you see here. All you have to do is answer 8 quick questions, and the surf skate selector automatically eliminates every model that won't work for you and spits out a very small list of only the best surf skates for you. And you can get the surf skate selector now by clicking the link in the video description below or by going to surfskate.love. Let me start with just a big picture overview of who and what these 10 surf skate trucks are best used for. So after testing them all out, I arranged them in a scale of pure surf trainers on the one hand to street cruisers on the other hand, and I'll explain to you what I mean by that. So on this side of the scale, I have the pure surf trainers, and that's your Sweltech, Curfboard, Smoothstar, Aquilo, and Spice Skate. Then on this side of the scale, I have your street cruisers, what I call street cruisers, your Carver CX and your Slide. And then in the middle here, we have 3 hybrids, by which I mean they can kind of do both the surf training thing and the street cruising thing, and that's the Waterborne Surf Adapter, the Amaraki, and the Carver C7. Now, obviously, as a non-surfer, I'm not qualified to make any commentary on any of these trucks as relates to surfing. I can't tell you which of these best replicate surfing and which you're gonna like best as a surfer. However, I can explain the measurable physical properties of them to help you make buying decisions at home. So the properties of them are the pure surf trainers on this side. First of all, they have very loose, smooth, fluid trucks, and that makes them very responsive to upper body movements, which, as I understand it, is very good for surf training. But as a result, that means that when you pump them, they tend to generate kind of like more lateral side-to-side motion with your front foot, as opposed to pulling you forward with more forward momentum. And so that means that in my experience, these pure surf trainers are best used for technical surf training in small areas on smooth surfaces, so things like cone drills on tennis courts. When we move to the other side of the scale, these trucks tend to get tighter and snappier, and as a result, I will tend to involve my lower body more when I pump them. So like when I'm on the Carver CX or the Slide, I'll use my ankles and knees more than I will some of these looser trucks on the right side of the scale. Now, there's one key difference on these street cruisers compared to the surf trainers, and that is when you pump them, they generate more forward momentum. And so as a result, I find them to be better for longer distances, and they are just more versatile for a wider range of applications. And so I want to make clear that just because I call these street cruisers doesn't mean that you can't use these for surf training as well. You can. In fact, there's a lot of surfers who will swear by some of these other ones as for pure surf training. But I just want to make the point that what I'm saying is when you move more to the right side of the scale, you're going to get more versatility out of these trucks. And when you move more to the left, it's going to be more of a specific surf training application. And another thing I want to mention too is that just because these are in the hybrid category doesn't mean that they can't compete with some of these pure surf trainers on the merits of pure surf training. You know, there's a lot of surfers who will swear by the Yao Muraki, for example, over the Smooth Star Thruster, and that's all just personal preference. But again, the reason why I put the Meraki in the hybrid category as compared to the Smooth Star Thruster is because it generates more forward momentum. So me as a non-surfer street cruiser, I can use the Meraki to go longer distances, whereas I'm not going to use the Smooth Star Thruster the way that I cruise for longer distances. Okay, so that's your big picture here. We got pure surf trainers, we've got hybrids that can do it all. They can do, they have the characteristics of the pure surf trainers, but they also have the characteristics of the street cruisers where you get the forward momentum. And then you have your street cruisers on the other end that probably aren't the best for surf training, but you can do a lot on them. Now, what skill level do you need to be at to consider each of these 10 trucks? Well, it depends on if you're new to all board sports or if you have some longboarding and skateboarding experience. But if you're new to all board sports, here's what I'm going to say really quickly. Swelltech, for advanced riders only. Curveboard is good for beginners. Smooth Star, I'm going to say better for intermediate riders. A Kilo is good for beginners. It's very stable. Spice Skate, I'm going to say good for intermediate riders. Waterborne, I'm going to say intermediate riders to start on. Yao, same thing, intermediate. Carver C7, intermediate to start on. And then these two, I would say, are good beginner boards, the Carver CX and the Slide. Now let's talk budget, and obviously this is all in US dollars, and you'll have to do your own currency conversions in your country, but in US dollars, for a Swelltech, you're going to invest between $219 and $279. For a Curve board, that's about $380 US for my Curve board. Smooth Star, I believe, around $360 to $375 US. A Kilo, I paid $310 US for this Kilo. Spice Gate have models ranging from $369 to this one is $429 at the highest end. The Waterborne Surf Adapter you can get alone for $59, or you can get it with the rail adapter for $79, or you can get a complete setup for between $222, and I think they have their carbon models as high as $499. Yao models are going to run you probably $360 to $375 US. Carver C7 models are $265 US. Carver CX models are $250 US. And Slide models are $220 US. Another thing I wanted to mention is how much each of these different surf skate trucks weighs, because that's an important point that affects the versatility that you have on these different trucks. Now, when I weighed these, what I was weighing was I took the surf skate truck off and I took the wheels off and I weighed the truck itself with the hanger. So pretty much everything that you would have on the front end of it. Okay, so your Carver CX is the lightest. This is 15 ounces. The Curve board is the next lightest at 1 pound, 1 ounce. The Slide is 1 pound, 5 ounces. Carver C7 is 1 pound, 6 ounces. The Swelltech is 1 pound, 9 ounces. The Smooth Star Thruster is 1 pound, 12 ounces. The Yao Muraki is 1 pound, 15 ounces. And then our three heaviest on the end, the Aquilo is 2 pound, 1 ounce. The Waterborne is 2 pound, 2 ounces. And the Spice Gate is 2 pounds, 9 ounces. And you're gonna see throughout this review that I'm a big fan of the Carver CX, and that's one of the reasons, is because it's the lightest, and that just means that you can do more. I just think that the more weight you have on that front truck, the more limited your applications are going to be with these. Another important aspect to mention about all these trucks is the rail-to-rail lean. And that's just personal preference. Personally, I like a deep rail-to-rail lean, but I'm just going to visually demonstrate these so you can see what they have. I have these arranged on the scale of what I think has the deepest rail-to-rail lean all the way down to the least rail-to-rail lean. Here's your rail-to-rail lean on your Yao Muraki, which, as I've said, I think of anything you see up here, this and the Waterborne have the most rail-to-rail lean. Here's your Waterborne Surf Adapter. And this is without a rail adapter, which would be more with a rail adapter. Here's your Carver C7. Here's your Spice Gate Spice Pilot. Carver CX. Slide. Here's your Smooth Star Thruster, which compared to the Carver C7 and the Yao Muraki has relatively lower rail-to-rail lane. Next, we get to the Sweltech, and the Sweltech is deceiving because you have a lot more range of motion than it seems, because you can go all the way this far, but your truck is jackknifing, so you can't actually utilize that range of motion. So you only can utilize about this much range of motion on the Sweltech before that truck jackknifes, so it's deceiving. The Kerf board does not have very much lean. You can add lean by adding risers, but relatively low rail-to-rail lean. And I think of all of these, the Aquilo has the least amount of rail-to-rail lean. Another important thing to note about all these different trucks is what I call the wheelbase offset. So when you ride a surf skate, you have to keep your front foot behind these front bolts, because if you're too far forward on a surf skate truck, your truck will jackknife. And so you have to make sure that you're always standing behind there. And the way different surf skate trucks are designed, your axle is going to hang back just a little bit further depending on the design. Now I have the Carver C7 here because the Carver C7 has what I call stance width equivalency, or wheelbase preservation. And what that means is, in the design of it, the axle doesn't hang too far back behind these back bolts. On the Carver C7, because that axle is actually hanging about right here on those bolts, it means you can utilize your front foot area all the way up to here on the Carver C7. Now, the reason why this is important to note is because the trucks that preserve wheelbase better allow you to have shorter decks to accommodate your stance width, which means that you have shorter, more nimble setups, as opposed to the ones where the truck hangs back more and offsets your wheelbase, okay? So I'm gonna walk you through how much each of these trucks offsets your wheelbase. The Carver C7 does not offset your wheelbase at all. It's the one that I use as kind of the baseline measurement that all the other ones are compared against. But I've got these arranged now to where, as you move further left, how I have them arranged now, you're gonna get more and more wheelbase offset. So actually, these four right here, the Carver C7, the Slide, the Kerf board, and the Waterborne, these actually all preserve your wheelbase. They don't offset it. That axle doesn't set back at all. Moving forward left, the Carver CX offsets your wheelbase by a half inch compared to the Carver C7. The Spicegate Spice Pilot and the Aquilo both offset your wheelbase compared to the Carver C7 by just 1 inch. The Yamaraki offsets your wheelbase compared to the Carver C7 by 1.75 inches. The Sweltech offsets your wheelbase by 3.5 inches. And the Smoothstar Thruster offsets your wheelbase by a full 4 inches as compared to the Carver C7. So what that means essentially is, if you're comparing a Carver C7 to a Smoothstar, you need to have a Smoothstar deck that is 4 inches longer than a Carver C7 deck to accommodate your stance width. And that means that the Carver C7s can be smaller and more nimble setups. And with the Sweltech and Smoothstar specifically, you have to add quite a bit of length to the nose of your boards to accommodate your stance width so that your truck doesn't jackknife. If you are a non-surfer beginner to surf skating, I'm going to say forget everything else except for two trucks, and that's the Carver CX and the Slide. I think out of all of these non-surfer beginners, really those are the only two that you should be considering to start with. Now, you might want to over time get some of these others, but I just don't think that you need anything other than these. Now, personally, I'm a Carver CX guy for a lot of reasons. If you go with the Slide, you are gonna save $30. You'll pay $220 for a Slide versus $250 for a Carver CX. But personally, for my money, I'd rather spend the extra $30 on a Carver CX. First of all, I just like the feel of the truck better. The Carver CX is a very simple bushing-based design. It's like the simplest design that you're gonna find out there. And then the Slide has a spring in it, similar to the Carver C7, where it's got a longitudinal spring running down this way with an adjustment nut on it right here. So you can adjust the Slide, but I find that the Slide is just not built with the highest quality parts. And so I have broke one of these springs on my Slide before, whereas you're not gonna have, I think, the breakage issues on the Carver CX. I do think that the Slide is probably a little bit more stable and better for total beginners to all board sports. So if you are a total beginner, then just in terms of stability alone, I think that you might want to be looking at considering the slide. But I also think that just given enough time, you'll pick up the Carver CX as well. So I don't know that that should make your buying decision, but it is something to consider. You also have more options with Carver models, which gives you more versatility in picking a board that works perfectly for you, whereas you have more limited options on the slide models. So all in all, I would call slide surf skates the budget street cruiser surf skates for beginners. A final reason why I prefer the CX over the slide is I just think that it's more versatile. I think that as you advance as a rider, you're going to get more performance out of the Carver CX than out of the slide. One advantage that the slide does have over the Carver CX is that it is lower to the ground. And so if you come from more of a traditional skateboarding background and you want to do things like ollies, I think it's probably easier to do that on a slide versus a Carver CX. What if you're a non-surfer and you've bought your first board, but you want to build a quiver over time of more surf skates? Well, here's going to be kind of the order that I would suggest it in. For your first time buy as a non-surfer, I'm going to say either slide or Carver CX. Then from there, I would say to consider either the Carver C7 or the Yao Meraki. And to be perfectly honest, if you're a non-surfer, there's probably no reason to have anything in your quiver other than any of those trucks, except for one reason only, and that's just you're a big geek like me and you just want to have them all just because it's interesting to you. But in terms of actual like training and skating, you don't need anything other than that. And honestly, if you get the Carver CX as a non-surfer, that's going to give you everything that you would ever need. Now, if you're a surfer, it's a bit more complicated for two reasons. Number one, I'm not the best reviewer for you, but number two, it's not just that you'll be considering these pure surf trainers, you will be, but you'll also, in my opinion, be considering these hybrids as well. And honestly, maybe even the Carver CX or the slide, because as I said, you've got a lot of surfers out there who will swear by the Carver CX for pure surf training. I would say that if you're budget conscious, go with the Carver C7, because of all of the pure surf trainers, the Carver C7 is $265, and personally, I think that that Carvers are actually more well built in terms of quality and longevity than anything that you see out here, and they're among the cheapest next to the slide. Now, I've done a lot of surveys and polls, and the one that always comes out on top is this Yao Meraki. This Yao Meraki I find to be an extraordinary surf skate truck. It can do it all, and it does it all very, very well. It's very well built. The Yao Meraki will last you forever. You might get breakages on your spring and your bearings, but those are all easily replaceable. It has fewer moving parts than the Smoothstar Thruster or the Sweltech. Now, the Sweltechs are cheaper. They are $220, but you're going to want to be an advanced rider to consider a Sweltech. Of these five pure surf trainers, I will tell you that my personal preference after test riding all of them is actually Spice Skate. If the only thing that I was going to be using a surf skate for is technical surf training in small areas and I had the budget for it, I would go with the Spice Skate. I think that this truck feels phenomenal. It has a very great turning radius. It has great rail-to-rail lean. It just feels really nice. The one disadvantage of Spice Skate is that it's pricey. So you're looking at their highest price model, their 830 Type X model. Spice Skate has three different trucks. They have their original, they have their Type X, and they have their Octo. The only difference between the original and the Type X is that the Type X includes two springs, the softer, looser original spring, and then you have a thicker, tighter Type X spring that gives you more rebound. My personal feeling is I don't think there's going to be hardly any riders at all, if any at all, that are going to prefer the original over the Type X. So when it comes to Spice Skate, my recommendation is to only go with the Type X, not the original. Unfortunately, they only include that Type X spring on their most expensive model, which is $429. So I don't recommend Spice Skate original trucks at all. And those Spice Skates are $369 and comparable to a Yao or a Smoothstar. So that's the one big disadvantage of the Spice Skate. And honestly, what I would probably recommend to surfers as your first surf skate is probably a Yao Meraki. The reason being is because I've just seen so many polls and surveys out there pointing to it from surfers, but also I think it's just a lot more universal than these other pure surf trainers than you're going to get. You can do a lot more on it. You get more forward momentum, you can do street cruising. So you get all of the same properties as the pure surf trainers. You get that smooth, loose, fluid truck. You get the deep rail-to-rail lean. Excellent for pure surf training. But also some of the other properties of the street cruisers that just make the Yao Meraki one of the most universal trucks up here. If you're a surfer starting out, I just think you can't go wrong starting out on a Yao Meraki. And as I mentioned, one big advantage of the Carver C7 and the Yao Meraki and the Spice Gate over the Smooth Star Thruster is that wheelbase offset. So if you go with the Carver C7, that's not gonna offset your wheelbase at all. If you go with a Yao Meraki, yes, you have to get a little bit longer Yao because that offsets you by 1.75 inches, but not nearly as much as that Smooth Star Thruster with the 4 inches. So you'll get the advantages of the Smooth Star Thruster, but without having to have that big long nose at the end of your deck. If you're a surfer, you really just have to test ride all of them to just feel it for yourself. But just from my own experience and how these feel and talking to surfers and seeing surveys and polls, I think that the very top ones you should be considering are the Yao Meraki, the Carver C7, the Smooth Star Thruster, and probably the Spice Gate. Those would be the ones that I would say to consider first. And the reason why I say those over the others is, well, Sweltech is only if you're an advanced, very advanced rider and a really great surfer. That's what that's for. So I think the Sweltech is probably not something that you start on, but something that you move up to over time. The Curve Board I find just to be like so kind of stable and tame that I don't know that there's going to be a lot of surfers who prefer that feel over these others, but I could be totally wrong on that. You'll just have to test it out for yourself. The big thing that I don't like about the Aquilo is that lack of rail-to-rail lean, but again, I have no idea what that's like in the water. Maybe that's more accurate to surfing than some of these others that have the deeper rail-to-rail lean. I don't know. But for me, it just comes down to a feel. I just prefer the feel of, say, a Carver C7 with deeper lean than the Aquilo. But that's just me. That's just personal preference. So the intended purpose of the waterborne is that instead of having to invest, say, $250 or more for a complete system, you can just buy the surf adapter alone for as low as $59, and you can slap it on any set existing setup that you have, whether it's a skateboard or a longboard, and you're going to turn that setup into an instant surf skate. So here's my take on the waterborne. First of all, does it work that way? Yes. But if you do it that way, are you going to get the best complete system? I don't think so, because a surf skate is a whole system. It's not just a slap on a surf skate truck onto anything. There's interrelationships between things. So I think that honestly, you're kind of hard pressed to put together a waterborne setup where you just get the adapter and put it on something that's going to be, especially if you're a beginner, it's not going to be quite as good as a complete system out of the box that you get from anywhere else, in my personal opinion. But will it work? Yes. Can it save you money? Yes. However, I do think that if you really like the waterborne surf adapter, that eventually you're probably going to want to get something else, like a Carver CX or a C7 or a Yao Meraki, and that you'll probably like those better than the waterborne surf adapter. But having said that, if you just want to dip your toe in the water and try out surf skating, then a waterborne is a great way to do that, as cheaply as possible. Personally, I prefer the feel of some of these other trucks over the waterborne. The waterborne has a very deep dive lean, especially when you add the rail adapter. This model has a wooden block, not the rail adapter, but when you add the rail adapter, especially, it has a very deep dive lean. And because it's a bushing based system, this runs off of a bushing in there. What that means is you'll lean deep into a carve and then it doesn't snap you back to that center. It doesn't bring you back up quite as quickly and with as much kind of snap as say the Yao Meraki or a Carver CX. And that's kind of the main reason why the waterborne isn't my favorite ride, but the waterborne is great. It does it all. It's a great hybrid. It's a great pure surf trainer, and it also generates a lot of forward momentum. So it's really great for longer distance pumping and just, you know, all around street cruising applications. So once you've chosen your surf skate truck, well, then your next step is to choose your different surf skate model. Well, that's a whole different complicated process in and of itself, but for now I wanted to just give you kind of a big overview of everything you're looking at in the market and the trucks that you ought to be considering. And to choose your model, that goes into other aspects, like you need to know what your stance width is, you need to know the characteristics of the deck and the riding application that you're going to be using it for. But I can just tell you, I'll save you all that research time right now by you can just go to surfskate.love and get my ultimate surf skate selector. Again, all you have to do is answer 8 quick questions, and that's going to eliminate every model on the market from these top 10 trucks that don't work for you, and give you a small list of only the very best models that work for you. So if you go to the video description below, you'll find the link straight to the ultimate surf skate selector. Go to surfskate.love, get the ultimate surf skate selector, invest 10 bucks and 10 minutes to save yourself hours of research. You don't have to do what I've done to find your best surf skate. You don't have to invest thousands of dollars. You don't have to buy all 10 of these surf skate trucks. I've invested all that money and I've done all the work and research for you. So go to surfskate.love and get your ultimate surf skate selector. Have fun playing around on that, but most importantly, go get your first surf skate and have fun playing on your first surf skate.